Let's turn this watercolor painting into a t-shirt design in Canva. Hello! I painted a bunch more parrot paintings over Christmas time. Here's a bit of tape peeling for you. There's more on my ASMR channel if you're interested. But I scanned the painting, I did the usual edits to the sun cornea in the free image editor GIMP, which you can download online. Adjusting the levels, sharpness, saturation, cropping, and removing the background. I've been making t-shirt designs of my paintings for merch by Amazon and other print-on-demand sites for a while by combining my art with some text. I've done the whole thing in GIMP before, but it can be a bit of a hassle and time-consuming, because GIMP really isn't the most straightforward or user-friendly tool for this. But recently I discovered a much easier and faster way to combine my art with text and even find ready-made t-shirt design templates to use as a base in Canva. And it's still completely free. Well, honestly, there's an extra step you have to do if you want it to be completely free beyond the free trial, but we'll get to it later in the video. So I'm doing the parts before combining the image with text in GIMP. You can do all of this in Canva as well, but you need to use the free trial or buy the subscription for the pro version. I'm only using the free version of Canva for now, and once we have a PNG image with a transparent background, let's move to Canva for the actual t-shirt design. You can just make a blank design and add your image and add text and add text and start from scratch. But what drew me to Canva was the templates that can actually give you ideas for your t-shirt designs. If you're not using the trial or pro version, first filter the templates so that you only get the free ones. Now, free template doesn't necessarily mean all the elements in the template are free, but we'll get to that. You can also filter by style, so I think I'll go with something feminine and script style for this. And once you've found the one you want to use, you can customize the template. Upload your image for the t-shirt and drag it into the template. Change the text and you can position it differently and change the colors and effects. I ended up having to cut my painting into two in GIMP because I needed to move the teacup. You can crop using the free version of Canva, but it didn't work well in this case. In GIMP, you cannot preview fonts. I usually end up searching for show my fonts on Google, and I put the text there and it shows the text in all the fonts I have on my laptop, and I choose one, go back to GIMP and select that font. So it's doable, but it's a bit clunkier. In Canva, I can see the image and text together and keep changing the fonts I choose based on the previews. Or you can of course use the ready-made templates that already have font pairings that work together and get an idea of what they look like with an image. One of my favorite effects you can do is curve. So you can easily curve the text and change how curved it is. This is another thing that you can do in GIMP, and I have done it for some other t-shirt designs, but it's very time consuming. I think I leave that comparison of curved text in GIMP and Canva to another video. Now we're getting to how to export your design. As I mentioned before, the free templates can still include paid elements, and then Canva won't let you export the design without paying. So in that case, go ahead and delete the paid elements, or you can copy-paste everything else but them to a blank new design. And in fact, you'll need to copy-paste everything to a blank design anyway. The t-shirt templates by default in Canva are too small to upload to print-on-demand sites. If you have the free trial or you have a Canva subscription, you can increase the size of the file you're downloading. With the free version, you'll need to do a workaround. Make a new custom template of the size you need. I'll use the Merch by Amazon t-shirt template size, which is 4500 by 5400 pixels. And then you copy-paste all of it to this new template and download that. This doesn't lead to any quality loss in Canva, but just in case, I usually like to do this first before I even add my image to the template. Now, the next issue is that with the free version, you can't download an image with a transparent background, so I'm going to open it in GIMP and remove the white background with the fuzzy select tool, checking how it looks on a black background before uploading the merch by Amazon. Well, the beak and feet kind of blend into the dark shirt, so I added the white outline for the bird. As a bonus, I'm also uploading this to Teepublic at the same time because it's just a fast upload process. No multiple different sized templates for different product types like merch by Amazon, and no hassle of having to adjust the same file for each product differently like in Redbubble. Just a couple of things I like to change. There'll be a link below to start your Teepublic shop, and if you want more print-on-demand tips, check out this video. See you there!